Hello guys, I'm making this tutorial for absolute beginners in 3ds Max. So let's get started. So Autodesk 3ds Max is a three-dimensional application. We call it as 3ds Max. That's a three-dimensional Studio Max 3D. So when I say 3D, so 3D is 3 dimension, one is X, one is Y, and one is Z. So 3 dimensions, you use this 3 dimensions for presentations. 3ds Max can be used in architectural. It can be used for entertainment, creating games, movies. Can be used for product designing. So if we say a kind of product designing, if you have any kind of a cell phone, so you want to design a cell phone, you want to model a cell phone, you want to brand it, so we can utilize this application for that purpose. So 3ds Max is an Autodesk application. Autodesk is a company. So the latest version for 3ds Max is 2020. So let's start with Autodesk 3ds Max. You can go and go using the version that is 2016. So let's start our programs, Autodesk, and start with this application. So we have this application opened up over here. So this is a user interface for Autodesk 3ds Max. So very first of all, we can see this is your command line. You can see your command panel. This is your command panel. This is your ribbons. So you can go over here, customize, show UI, you can activate and deactivate this stuff. This is your time slider. You can say your timeline, where you can see the frames. So these frames are utilized for generating animations. So this is your grid, you call this as a grid. Your coordinates, X, Y, and Z. This is called view cube. View cube is used for rotating the viewport. So these are four viewports. As you can see over here, it's written over here. That's your perspective view, your front view, your top view, and your left view. So this view, this is your menu bar over here. This is your outliner. Outliner, we can say, you can say select by name. So whatever objects you are going to create over here, you will be visible over here in the form of a list. So you can select it over here. So very first of all, how you can work with this user interface, it's very simple. So as you can see, you have right now four viewports. So you have four views, that is perspective, front, top, and left. If you want to change it, you can easily change it. You can just click over here and you can change the settings as front, back, left, right, whatever view you want, you can take it. And also you have some kind of shortcuts over here defined accordingly. So we can go onto this view, press Alt on your keyboard and middle mouse button pressed, and you can move the mouse to rotate the viewport. You can say rotate the view. As you can see, I can rotate it in all the axes, that is 360 degree I can rotate it. So this is a perspective view, you can say this is a 3D view. This view, that is a 2D view, 2D view, 2D view. These three views are 2D. If you go on moving this as 3D, as you can see, it will directly switch to the orthographic view. So we need to make it as a 2D view. Let's click over here and click it as a front view. These 3D views can only be scrolled, that is for zoom in and zoom out. And if you press middle mouse button, pressed and move the mouse, that is called panning the view. So these three views, you can pan it. This view you can rotate it, Alt, I repeat, Alt and middle mouse button pressed simultaneously and move the mouse to rotate the view, or you can rotate it by left mouse click over here and you can rotate it from view cube. Scroll it, zoom in and zoom out, middle mouse button pressed to pan the viewport. So over here we have two types of modeling over here in 3ds Max. One is called polygon modeling and the second is spline modeling. So when I say what is modeling, modeling is something like creating a 2D object into a 3D object. So for example, if you have a 2D stuff and you want to replicate it into 3D, transform it into a 3D, you can create it using, we call the term as modeling. So polymodeling, we deal with polygons like vertices, edges and all this stuff will be defined in the polymodeling. That's your 3D shapes. Spline modeling, we deal with the 2D shapes like lines, circles, rectangles for creation of different elements. So as you go over here, very first of all, right now we are not working with the units over here. So if you press Z on your keyboard, it will fit all this viewport onto its original position. So if you press G on your keyboard, it is going to hide your grid over here. You can easily on and off the grid. Wherever you require, you can on and off the grid accordingly. Let's take a plane over here and let's draw a plane right from the top view. So plane is considered as a flat surface over here. After taking this plane over here, if you press W on your keyboard, that is for move. So you can move the objects. So as you see, it's called manipulators, X, Y and Z. So W is for move. You can move it any axis. As you can see, this three are only showing you two axes, X, Y, Y, Z or X, Z. Over here you can see three axes. So W is for move, second that is rotate, E is for rotate. I repeat, E is for rotate. So you can rotate it. If you want to rotate any object at particular angle, you have a rotation over here, X, Y and Z. So for example, if you want to rotate this object to Y axis 90 degree, just set it as 90 and rotate it. So you can see the object is rotated to 90 degree. Again, if you keep it as 0 over here, it will get back to its original position. So W is for move, E is for rotate and R is for scale. So you can scale it. So if you want to scale it, you can scale the objects. So there are no units right now. I'm using this as a free transformation, free scale. So if you want to scale it from any of the axes, you can just scale it from X axis, Y axis, whatever axis you want. After that, if you press F4 on your keyboard, it is going to show you some kind of lines that are called wireframes. So you can see these wireframes help to subdivide the object. So you can click over here, that's a modify, and you can increase, decrease the length and width of your plane. So you have length segments and width segments. So segments help you to subdivide. If you want to do some kind of details in future, you can do this with this subdivision. So if you don't require it right now, you can just reduce it to 2x2. So right now, you can set up the units, the default units. If you go into customize, unit setup, whenever you open 3ds Max for the first time, the default units are as generic units. So generic units are normal units. If you are going to work with the feet and inches, so you can set up the size over here like decimal, feet, inches. So right now I'm going to set it as generic units and click OK over here. So W is for move, E is for rotate, R for scale. Now, what I can do over here is, like, if I press F3 on your keyboard, it's going to only show you a wireframe mode. That's not the shade mode, it's only a wireframe mode. Again, go back. If I press again F3, let's again create some another object. You can rename this object as ground. So as you rename it over here, as I told you over here, you got the display over here, you can on and off the object over here, as you see. So this is kind of a select by name, whatever you are going to create it. Click on this option, that's your create option, and you can create a box. So box, you can draw a box, go into modify, you can increase its length, width and height. So you can increase, decrease the segments of this and you can work it out. So same thing you will get, that is W for move, E is for rotate for all, you can rotate it, and R is for scale. So for example, if you want to rotate it at accurate 45 degree, so you can just click over here in what axis you want to rotate. You want to rotate in Z axis. So there is an option over here, that's your angle snap toggle. Activate this option, right click on it, and you have an angle. And let's say I take it as 45 degree and click OK. So now whenever I will rotate this object, it will only rotate in 45 degree because I have activated that rotation to, restricted that rotation to 45 degrees. So if I off this option and if I rotate it now, it can rotate freely over here. So okay, so how to maximize the viewport? You can press Alt and W to maximize any of the viewport. You click on the viewport and press Alt and W. So you can just go to create, take a sphere, you can draw the sphere right from the top view, create this over here, modify, you can use this radius, segments, smooth, you can increase, decrease it, and hemisphere. If you make it hemisphere, it's going to make it half over here. Right now I'm not going to edit any of the objects, this is a very beginner tutorial, so I'm just creating the objects. So as you can start up. Again, go to create. Let's take a cylinder over here, draw a cylinder. You can rotate this view on from all angles. So you can get radius for a cylinder, height for the cylinder, and you have segments. So segments, you say your height segments, that's your segments which are height, cap. Cap is considered as a tops, like a top part. Sides, sides will increase, decrease, depends on the detail. What you want. Slicing, if you go on the slicing part, it's going to slice it up. So you can slice this in and out accordingly. Alright. So now you can just check out all these different elements and work it out. So thanks for watching this tutorial.